Transmission-based precautions are applied when standard precautions alone are insufficient to stop the transmission of a microorganism. Respiratory and facial protection is required for organisms that are transmitted via the droplet or airborne route, or when airborne particles have been artificially created, such as during aerosol-generating procedures, or AGPs. The use of particulate filter respirators, known as P2 or N95 masks, is an important part of the personal protective equipment, or PPE, that health workers are required to wear as part of airborne precautions. They are applied to protect against the spread of infections via the airborne route. Respiratory protective equipment should cover at least the nose and mouth and is used to reduce the health worker's risk of inhaling hazardous airborne particles, including infectious agents. There are a range of devices that provide facial and respiratory protection, and these include surgical masks and respirators, with or without eye protection. In the majority of situations where respiratory protection is required, a surgical mask will be adequate. For a small number of pathogens that are transmissible via the airborne route, such as tuberculosis, measles, or chickenpox, or where AGPs involving infectious respiratory fluids are being undertaken on a patient, such as COVID-19, a respirator will be required. The most common respirator used in the healthcare setting is a disposable filtering half face mask. These videos will concentrate on disposable filtering facepiece respirators. In order for a respirator to offer the maximum desired protection, the seal between the respirator and the wearer's face must be tight. The two distinct procedures used to achieve this are the Fit Check and the Fit Test. To learn more about fit testing, please refer to the Clinical Excellence Commission's guidance on application of PPE, which is available from our website. In this series of videos, we will show you how to correctly fit check a P2 or N95 respirator. This is also called a user seal check. P2 or N95 respirators are available in a number of different brands, colours, models, styles, and sizes. When selecting a respirator, health workers should not rely on the specific colour of the respirator, but check the type of respirator by reading the label on the box or packaging. Please refer to the other videos in this series for how to fit check different styles of respirators. You should always read and follow the manufacturer's instructions for wearing and fit checking your particular brand of P2 or N95 respirator. This video only covers the use of disposable half-face P2 or N95 respirators. When providing care for patients with communicable diseases, additional PPE may be required based on standard and transmission-based precautions. Refer to the CEC Infection Prevention and Control Practice Handbook for more information. Remove glasses if wearing. Ensure long hair is tied back so it does not become tangled in the straps of the respirator. It is important to know that any amount of facial hair around the chin may prevent any of these respirators from sealing. An adequate seal cannot be guaranteed if you have facial hair. Follow the manufacturer's instructions for donning the respirators. The fit check includes both positive and negative pressure seal checks and should be performed as according to the manufacturer's instructions for each type of respirator. Perform a fit check or use a seal check every time you don a respirator and before entering an airborne precautions room. Check the positive pressure seal of the respirator by exhaling and negative pressure seal by inhaling while wearing the respirator. If air escapes between your face and the respirator, you do not have a good facial seal, and you should readjust the respirator and repeat the fit check process. If you are unable to achieve a good facial seal, you should not proceed with your clinical activity. You should check for the possible reasons, including the respirator has not been put on properly. For example, headbands are incorrectly positioned, hair or earrings are caught in the seal. Glasses or face shield are interfering with the seal. The respirator is the incorrect size or type for your face. Facial hair may be preventing an adequate seal between the respirator and the wearer's face. Speak to your educator or manager if you cannot achieve a good facial seal after addressing these possible reasons. An alternative style or size of respirator may need to be sourced and tried. Remember, fit checking must be performed every time you don a P2 or N95 respirator. Once you've fitted the P2 or N95 respirator, be careful not to compromise the fit and your protection. Do not touch the respirator while it is being worn. Reapply the respirator after it has been removed. Leave the respirator dangling around your neck or chin. Do change the respirator when it becomes moist. Wash your hands if you touch or dispose of a used respirator. Wait until you are outside the patient care area before removing the respirator. Dispose of used respirators in general waste bin unless contaminated with blood and body substance, where it will be placed into clinical waste. For safe removal, first perform hand hygiene. Lift off the top strap, lean forward and remove the respirator by pulling the straps from the back of your head forward. Alternatively, if the respirator has loops around your ears, lean forward, carefully pull the loops without touching the front of the respirator, and remove the respirator away from your face. Discard the used respirator in the general waste bin unless contaminated with blood and body substance, where it will be placed into clinical waste. Then perform hand hygiene. We now encourage you to find out what types of respirators are available in your workplace and watch the videos with specific instructions on donning and fit checking the type of respirator you may be required to use at work.